Welcome back, strangers. I'm Ethan with The Strangest. In 1973, two men went to the police claiming they had been abducted by aliens. The police obviously thought they were lying, so they left them alone in a room with a secret recording device. To their surprise, the men kept talking about what happened and how scared they were. What do you think they witnessed that night? On the night of October 11th, 1973, 42-year-old Charles Hickson and 19-year-old Calvin Parker Jr. were out fishing after work. The two co-workers were at a pier near the west bank of the Pascagoula River in Mississippi when they saw two flashing blue lights reflecting off the water. The men thought the lights were from an approaching police officer who had come to get them off the property. But then, out of nowhere, an oval-shaped object appeared in the sky along with the two flashing blue lights. They said they heard a loud, whizzing and whirling sound coming from the strange craft above them. It was 30 to 40 feet across and 8 to 10 feet off the ground when a blinding light appeared and the men heard a hissing sound and three legless creatures floated down from the craft. Charles and Calvin were conscious, but paralyzed, as the beings approached them. The three creatures had leather-like gray skin and crab-like claws. The men were grabbed by their arms and taken aboard the craft. They were examined thoroughly by something that looked like a floating eye. The beings took their time. They moved and acted more like robots than humans. Once the examination was complete, the men were left at the pier and the strange craft was nowhere to be found. Charles and Calvin were terrified. They took some time to compose themselves before deciding to report what had happened to the police. Charles needed three shots of whiskey to calm his nerves before he could leave the pier. The men arrived at the Jackson County Sheriff's Office at 10:30 that night. They came in so panicked and frightened by what had happened, the sheriff thought they had gotten spooked after a little too much drinking while fishing. The only evidence that they had that the men were remotely telling the truth were the catfish that they had brought with them that they had caught earlier that evening. The sheriff brought the men into a back room to ask them questions about the night and to take their statement. Charles and Calvin's story was so fantastic that the sheriff left the men alone in the room, which had a hidden microphone that recorded everything in the room. To the sheriff's surprise, the men did not stop talking about what had happened and what they had witnessed that night and how scared they were. Here is a clip of the recording of Charles and Calvin talking about the encounter they had while fishing. Many are still skeptical whether or not the story is true or a hoax that the men had come up with. Charles passed a polygraph test not long after the incident, but UFO skeptic Philip Klass believed that the test was administered by an inexperienced operator. Charles refused to take another polygraph test by a more experienced police operator. Over the years, there have been a few discrepancies in the men's stories. Calvin first told police they had passed out at the beginning of the incident and failed to regain consciousness until it was all over. Charles also said Calvin was unconscious the entire time during the abduction when he appeared on the game show to tell the truth a month after the encounter occurred. Despite this, Calvin passed his own lie detector test when he was asked about the events of the night of October 11th, 1973. Calvin said at one point he wasn't even sure the creatures were aliens. They might have been demons. He went on to say, "I'm a firm believer in God, and where there's good, there's bad." Strangers, what do you think Charles and Calvin witnessed that night on the pier? The tape is pretty convincing that the men actually were frightened by something, that they did encounter something that spooked them. But they'd also been drinking and it was late, so they could have easily been confused. I love alien and UFO stories, but I'm always skeptical of actual abduction stories. There's just so many things that it could have been instead, like, or they were just making it up. They did get a lot of recognition from the incident. They were immediately asked, like, by the news. They became really popular in the area and instantly became famous in the UFO community. Charles went on game shows, gave lectures, went on talk shows, and never turned down an interview after the incident. He loved it. He even wrote a book called Contact at the Pascagoula, which described the incident in more detail. He even claimed that he had three more encounters with aliens in 1974, and they told him that they were peaceful. Calvin soon kind of disappeared after the incident. He didn't like giving the interviews at first. He wasn't all about the fame like Charles was. I mean, he's given interviews since then and appeared at UFO conventions, and he eventually started his own production company called UFO Investigations in 1993 that was created just to air UFO segments and share his story on TV. Calvin was once hypnotized by Bud Hopkins, a prominent UFO investigator who helped tell the world of the men's encounter that night on the river. So the men did gain some money and notoriety from the incident. Is that what motivated them to fabricate the entire encounter, or did they actually witness unknown creatures that night? I do think the men were pretty quick to capitalize on the story. They were immediately right there. It was in the middle of the 1970s boom of UFOs and stories. UFOs hadn't been in the news that much since the 1940s. I think that year, 1973, was the highest reported year of UFOs of that decade. So they were right there on it, and they were given interviews, talk shows, everything. Eventually, Charles wrote a book. I mean, even Calvin came around and started his own production company. So there was something there. They got some money, but they kept to their story, kept it pretty consistent, minus those few discrepancies, and stuck to it. Charles did it to his dying day, and I'm pretty sure Calvin will soon be behind him. Do you believe the encounter was real or a hoax? Let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching, strangers. If you enjoyed this video, give me a like, subscribe if you're new, smash the bell button so you never miss out on our new videos, because I never know when I'm going to be releasing something, but I do enjoy making them for you. And as always, stay strange.